Hey, it's Thomas DeLauer with Antler Farms Wheatgrass, and today I want to break down the true science of wheatgrass. So you walk on into your local juice bar and they tell you that their tray-grown wheatgrass is going to give you all the power that you need to start feeling amazing and rid your body of free radicals. Okay, they're partially right. Wheatgrass is extremely powerful, but you have to be very particular with the kind of wheatgrass that you get. Now, I'm going to get to that at the end of this video, but first off, I want to explain what wheatgrass is. I want to talk about the specific benefits when it comes down to therapeutic uses, but also just overall good old-fashioned health benefits in general. All right, so let's talk about it. What is wheatgrass? See, wheatgrass is the shoot of a young wheat plant. Now, that doesn't necessarily mean that it has wheat or gluten in it, because a lot of times that wheat doesn't fully mature until it's much, much older. So you're essentially getting the shoot of a young plant, which is extremely, extremely nutrient dense. You see, wheatgrass is exceptionally high in what is known as chlorophyll, which is what gives grass its green pigment. Now, I'm going to talk a lot more about chlorophyll in this video, but first let's talk about a couple other things that wheatgrass has. Wheatgrass is exceptionally, exceptionally high in vitamins and minerals, particularly minerals like magnesium and zinc. And the reason is because it has a very low root system in comparison to the size of the plant, which means it can draw a lot of minerals from the ground and give you it in a very nice, small, concise package that you can get in a very easy way. But additionally, wheatgrass has some other powerful components. You see, it has a very high level of enzymatic activity. It's very enzymatically active. And what that means is that the different enzymes that are in wheatgrass can cascade into a lot of positive effects within your body. You see, they can stop certain enzymes from doing their job in the body, which can elicit a positive response, and they can also stimulate other enzymes to do good things within the body. I'll get to that in just a moment as well. The long and the short of it is that wheatgrass is very powerful. And when it all comes down to it, it's really the antioxidants that are giving it the big name. It's got a lot of power when it comes down to its ability to reduce free radicals in the body, and I'm going to talk about that in exquisite detail in just a minute. So first, let's talk about wheatgrass's ability to detoxify your body. It comes back to that chlorophyll again. You see, when chlorophyll is broken down in the body, it turns into something known as chlorophyllin. Chlorophyllin is the broken down form of chlorophyll when it's broken down into a digestible or water-soluble salt. It's this chlorophyllin that has a powerful effect on the body because it reacts with certain mutagens in the body and allows them to be excreted. What a mutagen is something that is sort of a mutant cell or causes DNA to structure in a different way. It's basically wreaking mutant havoc on your body. For example, a cancer cell would be considered mutant, right? It's kind of a regular cell that's gone rogue and done its own thing. Well, wheatgrass, because of the chlorophyll and ultimately the chlorophyllin, has the ability to neutralize that at least a little bit and package it up in a nice, easy way that the kidneys can process and ultimately excrete through the body. Now, additionally, remember those enzymes that I was talking about? Wheatgrass, since it's so enzymatically active, it induces what are called phase two enzymes. These phase two enzymes are literally the detoxifying enzymes within our body. They are designed to break things down and allow them to be excreted as well. So there's literally an enzymatic way that wheatgrass helps you detox, particularly when it has to do with something known as heterocyclic amine genotoxicity. Genotoxicity, just like mutagens, are basically when our genes become totally toxic. When our genes are toxic, our DNA doesn't send the right signals to structure the build-out. Imagine a blueprint for an office building that's totally torn up and people have had to kind of piecemeal together. It's not going to come out right. You're not going to get the right structure. That's what happens when you have a high level of genotoxicity. So once again, wheatgrass has the ability to negate some of that. Now let's move into wheatgrass's ability to help you when it comes to wound healing, when it helps with your leaky gut. Studies have shown that topical application of chlorophyll as well as ingestion of chlorophyll can help with wound healing. Particularly when it comes down to the skin and you put it on the skin, it allows a lot of nutrients to flood to that given area. And a lot of it also has to do with the massive influx of minerals that are going to that area. But on that same note, the Scandinavian Journal of Gastroenterology found that when you consume chlorophyll or when you consume wheatgrass, it has that same wound healing effect on your wounded gut. So when you have gut permeability, or when you have a quote-unquote leaky gut, chlorophyll can have a very profound effect in attracting nutrients there so that it can ultimately heal. It's also going to help with collagen production, which is why it's not only good for skin repair, but it's also good for your leaky gut, because a lot of times you're deficient in collagen when that occurs. Okay, now let's talk about the powerful antioxidant effects. When you go into a juice bar, you go into anywhere that's going to serve wheatgrass, they're going to tell you that the main benefits come from the antioxidant effects. And that is totally true, but they don't go into a lot of detail about how that works. You see, Oxidative stress is basically rogue cells and rogue oxygen that's flowing around through our body causing problems. When we have too much oxygen, it goes around and it oxidizes things. That's why it's called oxidative stress. Too much oxygen is not good. Well, there's a way that we can measure how much a given compound or nutrient can go around and gather up or absorb all of this oxygen that's flowing around through the body. It's called oxygen radical absorbance capacity, okay? ORAC. This ORAC, or absorbance capacity, is how capable a given compound is of absorbing all the oxygen that's flowing around. Well, here's the cool thing. Wheatgrass has such a high ORAC count that it's higher than almost all the fruits and veggies that are out there and in a much, much smaller package. So you can take a little bit of wheatgrass and have a very, very powerful antioxidant effect, whereas you would have to eat a lot of kale to elicit the same response. And again, a lot of it comes down to the bioflavonoids, but it also, again, comes back to that good old-fashioned chlorophyll. That chlorophyll and some of the other bioflavonoids in wheatgrass contain something known as superoxide dismutase. Just like the name implies, it stops that mutagenic effect, okay? But also what it does is it allows these free radicals to be processed into simple hydrogen peroxide and water where the body can process them and get them out of the system again. So you're kind of seeing a pattern here. Wheatgrass's job within the body is just to process things, package them up, and allow the body to do its job. It doesn't get in the way, it just makes it a little bit easier for the body to detox and for the body to heal. But now let's get to the part that you truly need to understand. Not all wheatgrass is created equal, and this is imperative. So why is Antler Farms wheatgrass a little bit different than the tray wheatgrass that you might find at your local juice bar? Well, first off, it's organic. That's a huge plus, but that's not super unique. We do see a lot of organic wheatgrasses. But what is extremely unique about Antler Farms wheatgrass is how it's grown. You see, it's grown outside over hundreds and hundreds of days, whereas tray wheatgrass is grown indoors and it's expedited. They try to grow it as fast as possible to increase the harvest so that they can sell more and get more out to market. But when it's grown outside, we have a huge benefit. The first one being the roots get a lot deeper. Remember how I mentioned wheatgrass is super high in minerals? Well, we have to remember that our soil is pretty depleted in minerals. So when we have roots that get down deeper into the soil, we can attract more minerals, attract more vitamins, and put it right into that short little shoot of the wheatgrass plant that we need to ultimately make wheatgrass. That's pretty darn cool right then and there. We also have to keep in mind that Antler Farms wheatgrass is grown in New Zealand. The soil is a lot more nutrient dense because it hasn't been over harvested. There's also a lot less pollutants in the air when it comes down to New Zealand. So we end up having a very powerful effect there. One of the other things that you have to be paying close attention to is when you get a wheatgrass powder, like if you go to the store and get one, a lot of times what it is a wheatgrass juice powder. They take the wheatgrass, they put it into a juice, and then they turn it into a powder. Whereas with Antler Farms, they actually cold press the wheatgrass itself, and you're literally getting wheatgrass powder versus wheatgrass juice powder. So you're truly getting the chlorophyll that you need, and it hasn't been lost through the juicing or through the extracting process. Extremely, extremely powerful and very important to pay attention to. What we have to remember is when wheatgrass is grown in a tray indoors, it's expedited so much that the only thing that really ends up in the wheatgrass are the simple sugars. There's always a little bit of sugar in wheatgrass, a very, very small amount, just like any plant or any starch. But when it's grown indoors, the roots are very shallow, and all you get is a lot of sugar and very low amounts of chlorophyll. You're also not getting the natural light, which is extremely important. And last but not least, when wheatgrass is grown indoors, the seeds are very, very close together. And since they're not getting a lot of oxygen because they're so close together, it breeds mold. Now, this may not be visible mold that you can see with the naked eye, but it's mold that does have a reaction in your body, which, when you think about it, kind of negates the entire purpose of having an antioxidant property of wheatgrass in the first place. The long and the short of it is that Antler Farms outdoor grown wheatgrass ends up having 4 times the amount of chlorophyll and 2 times the amount of protein of traditional tray grown wheatgrass. So I highly recommend that you check it out and make sure that you do your due diligence when it comes down to understanding the truth about wheatgrass and what it does in your body from A to Z. I'll see you soon.